Hello viewers, welcome to Elimu TV, a station where we are going to interact and learn together. We are going to have our baroids from 4 lesson 23, whereby your tutor will be me, Mr. Gerald. We are going to handle the topic on reception, response and coordination in animals, like the subtopic defects of the eye. Before that, we can have the following lesson goals, whereby by the end of the lesson, we should be able to state at least 2 defects of the human eye. The defects of the eye, these are structural changes in the eye which make the focusing mechanism of the eye difficult. Most of eye defects can be corrected after careful diagnosis by an optician, as plate show. The common defect they are short-sightedness, we have what we call the long-sightedness, we have astigmatism, we have squintedness, outsight, and what we call the color blindness, and also we can have cataracts. So now we are going to start with the first one, which is known as short-sightedness. So I am going to explain the short-sightedness. Our diagrammatic representation here is showing a normal human eye and another one which is the another human being which is short-sighted. So as I am explaining, you will be able to realize the difference between a normal eye and somebody who is being short-sighted. So a short-sightedness is, in other terms, referred to as myopia. And this is a condition in which light rays from a distant object are brought to focus in front of the retina, while those from a near object are clearly focused on it. This is caused by a long eyeball, as you can see from our diagram. It may also be due to too much refractive power of the eye lens. Short-sightedness is corrected by wearing concave or diverging lenses. The concave lenses diverges light rays before reaching the eye lenses, which then focuses the light rays on the retina, as you can see from our diagrammatic representation of our screen. We have our second defect of the eye, which is known as long-sightedness. And our diagrammatic representation here is showing a normal eye versus an eye with hypermetropy, which is also known as the long-sightedness. So hypermetropia is what we are referring to as long-sightedness. So I'm going to explain the difference that is there in the between the normal eye and somebody who is hypermetropic. This is a condition in which light rays from a near object are not brought to focus by the time they reach the retina. So as you can see, we have got that is for the case of the hypermetropia. We have the retina there, and the focal plane, that is, the image is being refracted beyond the retina. So by the time the light is reaching the retina, the image is not being focused. So we are saying that this is a condition in which light rays from a near object are not brought to focus by the time they reach the retina, as you can see from our diagram, while those from a distant object are sharply focused. It is caused by too short eyeball or a weak lens system. The disorder can be corrected by wearing a convex or converging lenses. This lens refracts light rays before reaching the eye lens, thereby enhancing refraction in order to focus rays sharply on the retina. We have got another defect of the eye, whereby we can have what we call the squintedness. Actually, this is an eye defect in which the extrinsic muscles of the eye that control the turning of the eyeball do not coordinate accordingly on stimulation. The defects affect the pair rectus muscles, which turn the eye up and down the lateral, and the lateral rectus muscles, which move the eye left and right. In this condition, the eyeballs face different directions, hence focusing and accommodation are achieved with difficulty. This defect actually is very difficult to correct. We have got another defect of the eye, whereby the defect we can have what we call the color blindness, whereby this is a genetic defect in which certain colors cannot be distinguished by human beings and other animals. A common type is red-green color blindness, in which the individual is unable to distinguish between red and green. Actually, most men are said to be color blind. The retina of the affected individual lacks cones with pigments that normally respond to green and red colors. At the moment, there is no cure for color blindness, but in future, with a breakthrough in genetic engineering, such genetic disorders may be corrected. There are more of our defects of the eye, which include also astigmatism, cataracts, we have what we call the outside, but this one we shall be discussed later on in our next lessons. Having done and said that, we can have the following activity, whereby you are required to you name at least two defects of the eye. And for more information on this lesson, you can refer to KLB, Secondary Biology Students Book 4, which is the 4th edition, Kenya Literature Bureau. And to get this lesson and many more of our biology lessons, you can send us an SMS through the number that is on our screen, or you subscribe to our YouTube channel, which is Elimu TV, or you subscribe also to our Facebook page at Elimu TV, or you tweet us at Elimu TV _Kenya. Let us subscribe to all these channels and we shall enjoy more of our biology lessons. Thank you.